Hi, welcome to Everything X-Carve. I'm Brian, and today we're going to go ahead and finish off part two of 3D printed parts for your X-Carve. Welcome back. So in the first part, I didn't want the video to go too long, so I figured I'd break it up and do a two-parter. This next one, I'll get a little more in-depth, a little up closer. Honestly, the last one was not my best video production I've done, but I needed to get back in the saddle. I haven't been doing this for a while, so I apologize if the video was a little shoddy on the last one. I promise this one will be better. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna walk through what remaining 3D printed parts that we have left. If you're familiar with any parts for the X-Carve or any other CNC machine for that matter, please feel free to comment down below on where we can find it and what it's used for. I think that'll just help everybody out in the community. And who knows, there could be a part three to 3D printed parts for your CNC machine. All right, so without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and get started back to the 3D printed parts. If you have the want to do a video of you carving and you happen to have a GoPro, this is on Thingiverse. It's the Mortise Mortician T3DM. This is something I found that you can print out, and then what'll happen is you attach it this way onto your spindle. Your spindle goes here and your camera will go here. I do have a GoPro and I could do that. I just don't know if I ever will. Tell me what you think about this. All right, so for this, put it on really, really tight here around to where you almost don't think it'll fit. That's by design and by intention. So make sure that you pay attention to when you're putting this on. Also to not hit your spindle lock. So don't know how often I'll be using this, if at all, but definitely, definitely cool to have should I want to. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to look at the Y-axis stiffener. I talked to the person that created these off of Thingiverse, sent them a message in Thingiverse, and asked them how well they worked. And he stated that they did reduce bowing and he hasn't had any problem with them. This is a good solution, cheap if you have a 3D printer. If you feel like you wanted to purchase them, I would look at places like TBDCNC or other shops that have created these specifically for the X-Carve. So what you do is you just put these in over here on the side and you come at it at an angle from down inside and then you would push it in.
Okay, so you just want it to where you've got your nut in there. But you'll also want to make sure that the nut looks like that, so that way when you slide it into the track and you expand it, twist it, it's going to lock into place. So just do that on each side. Repeat with the other five or however many you decide you want to do to stiffen and place them in.
All right, so the first thing we want to do is we want to split up. I've got six of these. So what we'll do is we'll split up and we'll put in three on each side, equally distance apart, to give it the a reduction in bowing. So we'll be right back after that's done. So after doing some measuring, I found that mid-span of this is 19.75 inches to the middle. And then you want to take a look and go roughly from the middle here, 9.5 on each side. That way you get a nice, good, even span. I've got them measured, and then I've done a little Sharpie, which you can't really see because of the black gantry. But the easiest way to put these in is to take your bolt and put that through a little bit, and then your T-nut that's going to fit right in, and then once you start locking it into place, it'll twist up and lock in. So you'll want to do that with each one of these first, and then that way you don't have to worry about maneuvering with this in the slots, you can just lock it in. So I'll get that done, and then we'll get right back to you. So with the 3D stiffeners, I mean, these are just, they're PLA plastic. They're probably not gonna hold up over time, and obviously metal is gonna do 10 times better than what these stiffeners could do. But I wanted to give it a try. So far, just installing them, I could see that the railing's a little more sturdy. So that's definitely, you know, it's a step up in the right direction. Until I can look at alternatives, such as the metal ones that could be found by a couple different providers that are in the CNC community, and I'll link those down below in the description of the video. So the Y-axis gantry covers, they're really quite convenient, and they're actually pretty easy to do. You've got a 1-inch brush here that comes right out. That way you can replace them. Really easy to replace. I got this from McMaster Car, a website, and I'll link that down below. Now, if you know where to get that off Amazon, please feel free to share. And that way I'll post it and change the description link there. And then I just got some magnets. And I'll post the link to where I got those 5mm magnets, as well as some Gorilla Gel super glue to lock those magnets in place. They work great, and they're also going to reduce the amount of dust that's going into your spindle wheels, which is going to reduce the amount of time that you're spending cleaning them. So, great print to have, and not too much on cost to get that replaced. The next piece is this right here, which is a Sharpie pen holder. This is done by designsbyphil.com, and he did a really good job with this. Why would you need a Sharpie pen on your machine? What's the use? What's it for? The first thing I thought of is with a brand new wasteboard, I don't have any grid lines, and I don't have a laser to do grid lines as quick and easy as it would be to do it with something like this as an alternative. Now, a few caveats to this. Your wasteboard needs to be completely trammed and level completely. Otherwise, as this goes across, it's going to raise and lower, and eventually your Sharpie that you put in here is going to end up going across your wasteboard or not hitting it at all. And I will show you what that looks like here. He's done a really good job with changing this up. So I gotta give it to him. I think this is really cool. Downside is if you're running a glass bed and you're using ABS, which is what this is, be careful. You could end up ruining your glass bed. I don't know if you can see here, and I'll put it in up on this camera here. That little mark that you see is actually glass that's been embedded in. It broke my old 3D printer. And I'm glad it did, because my new 3D printer is the Artillery Sidewinder X1. It was just under $400. It's got a bigger build volume, it's quieter, and you know, if you're gonna do something like this, it's gonna pay for itself just in X-Carve parts that you're doing, or any other CNC part, by just buying your own machine. They're very easy to run. Probably even a little bit easier than a CNC machine. That's how I got started, is I had a 3D printer first, but definitely a really cool tool to do this. Moving forward, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna look at another 3D printed part, and This will conclude the 3D printer part video, but this is the new spindle pen holder mount. And this is also done by Designs by Phil. It's a lot more versatile. You have these 4M screws, and what these screws will do is they will help adjust the amount of tension that's on your pen, or marker for that matter. I saw a video where somebody put dry erase markers in and then put a dry erase marker down on the board, and it was pretty cool, I have to say. But this is a new step. I've already done one little thing with it. Matter of fact, I'll get that now. But I did this with this. And the level of detail that the machine did just for that, definitely worth the purchase. To use this to align maybe grid lines, it's a little more forgiving than this when running, because this is going to keep constant tension down, whereas this with the springs that you can also print out, they're probably not as reliable. Still a great tool, I have to say. I love this, but this is an amazing tool. This is awesome. So if you want to get one of these, designsbyphil.com is where you would need to go to get this. And it just attaches to the spindle. So we're going to attach it to the spindle. We'll get it set up. We'll get something in, and we're going to draw out everything X-Carve on the top of the waste board. And I'll do a little time lapse for that, and we'll be right back.
All right. So all you do is line it up with your holes here on your spindle mount. Get that lined up where you want it. And then over here on the right side, you just want to make sure that you've got it set somewhere decent here. I always go just right to the top. And then, you know, to find your hole, screw that in. Screw your other end, make sure nice and tight, not gonna move there. And then you've got to choose your weapon. You can do just some black felt, or you can do ultra fine tip. The ultra fine tip are probably what I'm gonna go with here. Drop down a piece of paper. Get that lined up the way you want.
So that's it for part two of 3D printed parts for the X-Carve. If you like what you saw, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more, consider subscribing. Don't forget, we've also got a Facebook group, Everything X-Carve, that has a lot of people there to help you out. No question is a dumb question. We're not the type of group that says go Google it. We really do want to be there to help you. So until next time, see you later. Have a great day.